Welcome to Augment Deck. We coach engineering students and working professionals for better career opportunities. Before we start learning about humidity, we need to know a basic information about air. The fact that air has the ability to hold water. To understand humidity, we'll make an analogy. Think of air contained inside a bottle. This air does not contain any water vapor. So, this sample of air is known as dry air. If some holes are made on the surface of this bottle, they will determine the maximum amount of water vapor the air can hold. If we try to fill this bottle with water, water up to the limit of holes can be filled. After that, water will be precipitated out. In the same way, air has the ability to hold water vapor. If somehow the water content or the moisture content in the air exceeds this limit, it is precipitated out in the form of water. At higher temperature, air can hold more water vapor. So now these holes can be thought at higher position. In the first three examples, if you see any blue region, that means it says us about the strength to which the air can hold water. But there is no actual water vapor present. It just says the maximum amount of water vapor the air can hold. In the last example, let's say there is some actual amount of water vapor present in the air. This kind of air is known as unsaturated air. Because air is not holding moisture up to its maximum strength. If there is any sample of air which contains water vapor up to its 100% capacity, this type of air is known as saturated air. Humidity ratio. It's an important concept, so I'll repeat again. This is a sample of unsaturated air. And the dark blue region is shown as the amount of actual water vapor present, and from the bottom of the bottle up to the holes shows the maximum amount of moisture the air can hold. In the other diagram, a sample of air is shown where there is a dry air section and some amount of moisture present. To define humidity ratio, the ratio of mass of water vapor and the mass of dry air is taken. It's a very important point to note over here that humidity ratio has got nothing to do with the maximum amount of water vapor the air can hold. This is the reason why the first diagram is shown. So we can write humidity ratio as W equals to MV by MA. Humidity ratio is denoted as capital W. And there's another fairly complicated formula which won't be used quite frequently. Just for your reference, it is shown. Relative humidity. It is the ratio of actual moisture in the air to the maximum moisture the air can hold times 100%. Unlike humidity ratio, relative humidity is related to the maximum amount of water vapor the air can hold. Relative humidity is represented by phi. So phi equals to mv by mvs. Mv is the mass of actual water vapor and mvs is the mass of maximum water vapor the air can hold. This can also be written as pressure ratios. And one more formula just for your reference. Because it is a very important term, so we'll do an example to understand more about relative humidity. So let's say at 25 degrees centigrade, there is a sample of air. This air has maximum moisture holding capacity at 60 grams. Just to make calculations simpler, these kind of values are taken, though practically it may or may not be possible. So the maximum moisture holding capacity is 60 grams and the actual moisture present in the air is 30 grams. So if we use the formula, we end up getting relative humidity as 50%. If we increase the temperature of same sample of air, the maximum moisture air can hold now goes up. So let's say the maximum moisture the air can hold now is 80 grams. So the same sample of air now holds more amount of water vapor because it is at a higher temperature now. But the actual moisture present in the air remains the same. So now relative humidity comes out to be 37.5%. This example illustrates you the dependence of relative humidity on the maximum moisture holding capacity of air or the temperature of the air. On changing the temperature, though the actual amount of moisture in the air remains the same, its relative humidity changes. Degree of saturation. To find degree of saturation, find the humidity ratio of a sample of air. Then find the humidity ratio of same sample of air when it is saturated. On doing the ratio of these two ratios, we get degree of saturation. This has to be at same temperature and pressure. Now one can have doubt as how are the water content in these two samples different even though temperature is same. To clarify this, you can see the top portion of the bottle where holes are made. The holes on the two bottles are at same height. So their maximum moisture holding capacity remains the same. So degree of saturation can be written as humidity ratio over humidity ratio of saturated air. It is denoted by the letter mu. Absolute humidity. Absolute humidity is the total mass of water vapor present in unit volume of moist air. So to find absolute humidity, we need to have unit volume of moist air. It can be 1 cm cube, 1 meter cube or 1 liter. Based on that, it will have different units. So if we have a sample of air, to find absolute humidity, we do the ratio of the mass of water vapor to the total volume of moist air. If we say the total volume of moist air to be 2 meter cube, and in this 2 meter cube, the mass of moisture or the water vapor present is 60 grams. So absolute humidity comes out to be 30 gram per meter cube. This says that in 1 meter cube of moist air, the mass of water vapor or the moisture present is 30 grams.